My other employees pulled up. Mm-hmm. I heard a little bit of like kind of commotion or screaming. I didn't think anything of it. She never came inside. I just went out there to get her out of her car. Her purse is in her car. She's not anywhere to be found.
As I was walking by communications, I'd heard some radio traffic that sounded like a pursuit going on. I stepped in, asked what they had, and the radio operator advised me they had a pursuit going towards Iowa Park that had come, that was involved a kidnapping suspect that had come out of Oklahoma. I told him I'd head out that way, see if I could, you know, help in any way.
The victim had actually been kidnapped out of the Norman, Oklahoma area, and they had traveled into Texas when a local police officer had found that vehicle, and that's when the pursuit had started.
I left the office, and as I was catching up to the pursuit, the suspect was getting back onto the highway, one exit up ahead of me. I was able to maintain with him. He had avoided spikes a few times on the highway, and as he got closer to the next exit, he could see up ahead there was another set of spikes. He took the exit, and when he got back on the southbound side of the highway, he had turned and went the wrong way up the highway going north in the southbound lane. He was spiked successfully in Oakley Union by one of our troops out of Vernon, and I could tell that he was starting to lose air in the tire. I saw the suspect vehicle exit the road. I thought it was a crash based on the amount of dust and debris that had flown up into the air and I had seen. As I pulled up on the scene, I actually observed a female come running out of the vehicle towards my patrol car.
Once Josh showed up on the scene and parked his car, the victim who had been kidnapped out of Oklahoma jumped out of the vehicle and began running back towards Josh and to escape the person that had kidnapped her. The suspect in this case had tackled the victim and began stabbing her.
As I was exiting my car, he sat up, he looked at me, and he began to stab himself. And then he laid back down on top of the female victim. I drew my service pistol, gave him orders to drop the knife. He didn't comply. I discharged my firearm, striking him, knocking him off of her. I'd hit him a couple times, and then it's kind of like he got his second wind, and he sat back up, and he just continued to stab her in a very brutal manner. At that time, I ran up to close the distance and try to save this female from going through what she was going through. I discharged my firearm a few more times. We were able to eliminate the threat.
What he was able to do is fire upon the subject. In fact, he hit the subject multiple times as he walked towards the subject and put every round on the subject, for that matter.
Corporal Moore successfully neutralizes the subject, stops him from repeatedly stabbing the victim, but then immediately rolls into a care mentality.
Lay down. Lay down. Just breathe. Hey, can you hold my hand?
Please give me my mom. Hey.
Lay down. Lay down, sweetie.
He has to, at that point, it's all about saving that young woman's life. And him and the responding officers did an amazing job.
I really hope that she continues to get more help. But I honestly believe that because of him, not just the fact that he saved her life, but because of him, she is here, mentally and physically.
I think the biggest thing I would say is this one event does not define the type of trooper Corporal Moore has been. He's been an excellent trooper over the years. I think this is just now an opportunity for everyone else to see what type of trooper he is.